Hello and welcome to Umbraco Learning Base, Jonathan here. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can upgrade your Umbraco Cloud project to the latest major version of the Umbraco CMS and its associated packages. Before we get started, let's have a quick look at the prerequisites that your cloud project needs to have before you can upgrade to the latest version of the Umbraco CMS. Great, let's take a look together. So first of all, you need to follow the requirements for working locally with the Umbraco CMS on your computer. I'll add the documentation in the description down below. You also need to have the latest .NET version installed locally on your computer, as the latest version of Umbraco is always running on the latest .NET version as well. You also need to run the latest version of Umbraco, and we recommend that you have at least two environments, as if anything goes wrong, you can always delete the second environment. Great! Now, let's go ahead and upgrade an Umbraco Cloud project to the latest major version. Let's get cracking. Okay, now let's get started with upgrading to the latest major version of Umbraco on our Umbraco Cloud project. The first step that we need to do is that we need to go up here to the settings and go to the Advanced tab. This is because we want to update our cloud project to use the latest version of .NET. We need to do this as the latest version of Umbraco always runs on the latest version of .NET. So in this case, we are upgrading from Umbraco 10, and Umbraco 10 is running on .NET 6. However, on Umbraco 11, the version we want to upgrade to is running on .NET 7, so therefore we need to update the runtime setting. We do this by going in here to the runtime settings, and here we can choose .NET 7. We can see that the change will take effect and it will restart the environment. So go ahead and confirm. We also need to do it for our live environment as well. So let's go ahead and change it here as well. And click confirm. Great. Now that we've updated the runtime settings, we can see that it's updated here and it's updated over here as well. And once it's done restarting, we should go ahead and clone down our project. So we do this by going up here to our development environment and clicking on the small arrow. And let's click clone project. So we click it here and we get the clone URL. Let's copy it and go to our clone tool here. I'm using fork in this case. So let's click clone and we see it adds it here. And let's just choose a proper folder for our project. So let's take cloud projects here. Select the folder and let's clone it down. Great. Now we've cloned down our project. Let's go ahead and open it up. So let's go to the project here and go to the folder here. And let's run the Umbraco project solution down here. Okay, so let's first go ahead and build our solution. And once the solution has been built, we can see it has succeeded. We can go up and start our project. We can see that the website is being initialized. And once it's done, we can go ahead and restore our content from Umbraco Cloud. So let's go ahead and restore our content from Umbraco Cloud by clicking the green button. Great. If we try and refresh the site, we can see that now we have our content from our site here. And if we quickly take a look at the back office as well, and sign in with Umbraco ID, we can now see that we have our content here, and in the back office, we have our document types as well. Great. Now we can go ahead and start with upgrading our project to the latest major version of Umbraco. Okay, so before we move on, we need to go to our project up here, and let's go and right click on it. Go to properties down here, and in here we need to change the .NET target framework to .NET 7, just like we did on our Umbraco Cloud environments. So we go here to our target frameworks, as you can see. And as we can see, it's on .NET 6 right now. Let's go ahead and change it to .NET 7 here. Great. And once it's done, we can now go ahead and start with upgrading our Umbraco Cloud project. To do so, we need to go up here to Tools and go to NuGet Package Manager. Let's go to Manage NuGet Packages for Solution. Great. As we see, we have the installed packages here, and we need to now update them. The first one we should update is the Microsoft Extension Dependency Injection Abstraction Package. We need to upgrade that to the latest version, latest stable version, which is version 7 here. So let's go ahead and install it. Great. As you can see, it's now been installed, and we can now move ahead and upgrade the Umbraco CMS to the latest major version. Great. So now that we have upgraded the Microsoft Extension Dependency Injection Abstraction, let's go ahead and update the Umbraco CMS and all its associated packages. To see which packages has updates available, we can go up to the Updates tab here. And here we can see the Umbraco CMS down here and all the associated packages that also need to be upgraded to the latest stable version. So let's take off all the packages here as they all need to be upgraded to the latest major version. Once it's all ticked off, we can go ahead and click Update up here. This will update all the Umbraco packages for Umbraco Cloud. So let's go ahead and update it. And as you can see, all the packages are now being installed. So let's wait for it to finish up and also make sure to accept all the license acceptances as well if they pop up. Great. Let's take a look at installed packages. And if we look out here on the side, we can see that they're all now upgraded to the latest major version, which is Umbraco 11 here. So we scroll down just to have a look here. Awesome. Now let's go ahead and build our project again. So once the project has been built, we also need to update the app settings with the unattended upgrades feature, so that we can verify the upgrade without having to accept it. So we go in and add it here in the app settings file. Let's just delete this and let's save it. And once it's been saved, let's go ahead and run our project. And now behind the scenes, the project will be upgraded. And as we can see the front end here. And let's go to the back office to verify that the upgrade has actually gone through. So let's sign in with Umbraco IDE again here and say no thanks. To check if the upgrade has gone through, we can go up here and click on the logo. And as you can see, we have now upgraded our project from version 10 to Umbraco 11.1.0. Awesome. So now we've successfully upgraded our project to the latest major version of Umbraco. Now, the next step is to close down our project again here. We can now go ahead and remove the unattended upgrade again. So now when the project is running without any errors locally, the next step is that we want to deploy the changes to our cloud environment. So let's go ahead and do so. So now let's go to our cloning tool here. And as you can see, there is quite a few changes. Let's go ahead and stage them all. Let's call this upgrading to Umbraco 11 here. Commit the files and let's go ahead and push them up to our cloud environment. And as we can see, it's now being pushed. And I can also follow along here in this activity log as well to see how the deployment is going as well. Great. We can now see that the deployment has been completed. So let's go to our cloud environment up here and let's try and refresh the site and see. And great, as you can see on the development environment, it is now running Umbraco 11.1.0, it's running Umbraco Forms 11.0.1, and it's running Deploy 11 as well. So now we successfully upgraded our cloud environment to the latest major version of Umbraco Cloud. The next step is that we want to first check if everything works as it should on our environment. So we view the front end and we view the back end as well, just to make sure that everything works as expected. So far, so good. The back end, everything looks like it works as expected. And on the front end, everything works as expected as well. The last step is then to deploy the changes to your live environment. So let's go ahead and deploy it to live. We can see that it's now preparing the deployment. If you want to follow along in the details, you can always view the details down here and see what's happening in the activity log as well. So let's go ahead and wait for it to finish up deploying from development to the live environment. Great. I'll see you in a bit. See that the deployment has completed. Now let's go ahead and update the browser again to see if the update has gone through. And awesome. As you can see, our live environment is now running Umbraco 11.1.0 as well, and Forms 11.0.1 and Deploy 11 as well. Fantastic. And now we've updated our cloud project to the latest major version of Umbraco. Let's just for a safe measure check the front end and see if everything works as expected. And as you can see, everything works as expected. And let's take a quick look at the backend as well. And here, everything works as expected as well. We can see up here that we are indeed running Umbraco 11 now. Awesome. So in this video, you've seen how you can upgrade your Umbraco Cloud project to the latest major version of the Umbraco CMS and its associated packages. Thank you so much for watching this video. My name is Jonathan, and I'll see you in the next one. Jonathan out.